Should we pull the table?
That's a good idea.
Can we move the table?
Yeah, yeah.
We've done it. Look at that. Skills.
I always think this whole spiel should be part of the interview. This all should go in.
Yeah, exactly.
It's the best bit.
Yeah.
Well, hello and welcome to Tipsy Talk with none other than Emilia Clarke.
Hi.
Very excited to have you here.
Thank you very
and
much.
And to have tea.
I know. This was my set.
Oh, it was. It's the
it
shop.
It was. It is the shop. This is the view behind my little counter.
No, we don't usually have tea, but...
Yes.
It was your birthday yesterday.
It was my birthday yesterday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you so much.
A video is circulating the internet.
I know. I thought that was a brilliant idea. I was like, that'll be funny. Let's just do that. I do love Panorama. Like, I love Panorama. But now I'm slightly regretting it because every interview I've done, someone's given me another one.
I'm so glad you said that because I did think, will I get her one on the way? And I was like, no, I'll be the fifth person today.
Enough.
Stop it.
We can't eat any more Panorama.
Funny enough, that's what I was eating when I saw this film.
Oh, nice.
What a good
choice.
What a
that's
good
very good.
Well,
that's
I was also, good. You're not allowed food in these screening rooms. So I was
no.
like, I snuck it into a little
bit. I always sneak food into screening rooms. Okay.
So usually we get a little tipsy.
Oh, very nice. Lovely. I'm going to look at that.
To God. Be fair, my favourite part of my job is just having wonderful people serve me.
There
drinks.
We go.
This is great.
I
look
do have
this.
Catering experience.
Do you,
you know?
Indeed?
Oh,
when
yeah.
was this?
When I was before drama school and then after drama school when I was unemployed.
Do you
that's
take milk,
when.
Amelia?
I shan't. No, I might just
no,
have it without milk.
Love
yeah.
It.
Before and after drama school, I did a million different jobs and catering was absolutely one of them.
How did you find that?
Yeah, it was all right. It was good when you were so broke you couldn't afford dinner because then when you're doing the canapés, I don't know if anyone knows this, but if you're at a fancy event and you've got someone passing around the canapés, if there's one left, you can't walk around with it. So you have to take it back to the kitchen. So I would get to the point where I'd be like, you want that one? No, you don't? Great, because I'm going to have mine.
I didn't yeah. know this. What an interesting role.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it prepares you for the real world, I think.
It does.
And then when you go on to do other things. And it also,
it
I think,
does.
keeps you a bit grounded because then obviously you go off out into the world and you become Emilia Clarke, as we know and love today. And I think there's something nice about kind of having that grounded experience.
Yeah.
But then you're always going to treat everyone on set the same. And
yeah, my dad was in the was a sound designer for the theatre. So I was raised by someone who was in the crew. So
right.
I was raised to just be as professional
yeah.
as you can. You are the least important person on that set. Don't behave like you're anything else.
We're here to talk about Last Christmas, obviously.
Yes. Ta-da.
Now, I'll confess something.
Yes.
I'm a bit of a cynic.
Okay.
They'll know. So I went in feeling like,
we had to,
Christmas
we had to,
schmaltz,
yeah.
oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
And I came out melted.
Oh, good.
You melted me.
Thank
it's
you so much.
Just very warm.
Yeah.
It just feels very warm. Was
oh,
it like
good.
That on set?
It was. Well, you've got Paul Feig, who was just the single nicest, most glorious person in the world.
I'm so sorry, I'm trying to
okay. No, I know, did. I did the thing as well,
slightly
where I was like,
terrifying.
Trying to not make too much noise.
Paul Feig is just an unbelievable delight of a human being. And Emma Thompson, I mean, come on. She's just such a babe.
Yeah.
And I always say this, it's a bit of a weird phrase, right? But bear with me. The fish stinks from the head down. If you are having an unhappy filming experience,
oh,
it's largely because... The,
yes.
the people at the top are not very nice because
yeah.
it filters down. And so when the fish's head is really lovely, it will also smell lovely all the way down. It's
so
a fresh fish.
When the fish has a lovely head,
yeah.
everything works well.
Everything's great.
Brilliant.
It was just a genuinely, for want of a better word, a jolly set. We had a really lovely time.
And you mentioned Emma there. I mean, she's Emma Thompson. She's so iconic.
Just
and,
ridiculous.
You know, was the star of one of my favourite scenes of any film, let alone a Christmas film, which is that scene in Love Actually.
Joni Mitchell.
Stop.
The CD.
Yeah.
Right? I know. And she just... God, stop
straight
the best bit of acting!
But it's magical.
It is magical.
And there's something about Christmas films, I think, that kind of...
I know. We're at our most vulnerable at that time, I think. People keep asking me, like, do you like Christmas? And I've realised why I like Christmas now. Promoting a Christmas movie is how I've realised it. Everybody's on holiday at the same time.
Yeah.
Largely speaking, obviously,
yeah.
largely speaking, not everyone in the world. But in the Western world, largely speaking, religious or not, you're going to get some time
yeah.
off. The energy in the air is of a lot of people who are about to have a holiday. And it, I don't know, and then we're all in it together.
Even when you're working, there's something quite nice.
Yeah.
About it. It can be absolutely lovely. And as I said, this melted my heart. And it's very funny.
Thank you.
It's very funny. I was
Thank you.
Properly laughing out loud. And
oh, good.
It doesn't take itself seriously. You know, it's very light and it's very fun. And then it tackles some quite big issues as
yeah.
well.
Emma and Greg couldn't write anything that wasn't in line with their political beliefs. And I think what
yeah.
it does is it's all of this.
of the Christmassy vibes. Oh, the jolly, jolly goodness. But then it's also reflecting Brexit. It's reflecting today. Yeah. It's reflecting hate crime. It's reflecting, you know, being an immigrant in London. We do sneak all of these kind of slightly bigger messages into this, like, Merry Christmas! There's a lot in here!
Politics.
Dive in!
Politics, but Christmas! Yeah. But death, but Christmas!
But exactly, but death, but Christmas, yeah. The thing that I loved about Kate the most is that she is kind of, I keep saying this, she's like the anti-heroine. I recognised her from myself, from my friends, my demographic. I'm like, I know who that girl is, and she's kind of all of us, and she's not always in a good mood.
Yeah.
And she doesn't feel like she needs to be. She's the heroine in the piece, but she's not perfect.
It's difficult to play that kind of a character. He's quite selfish and a bit mean at times, and you know, sometimes you're like, I wouldn't want to hang out with that girl.
Yeah.
And yet be endearing and charming and sort of...
Thanks.
You're welcome. Acting. It is my job, Hazel. That's what I do.
It was just getting to grips with all of the reasonings behind it. And I think that's, I don't know, that's a lesson that I've learned in life 100% is that you meet someone and they're in a bit of a bad mood. You have no idea what they've been through. You have no idea what has made that happen. And if we had, all of us had a little bit of kind of generosity of spirit when you see people to not just cut them off straight away, then, you know, you might get that back for when you need it, for when you're like, I'm having a bad day.
Bit of compassion.
There we go.
Was it nice to make a film where you were like, this is important?
Yes.
We're making an important point here.
Yes, absolutely. I live in London. I count myself as a Londoner, and in the continuing turbulent sea that is Brexit, it really brings a lot of your own beliefs and feelings into the light, and opening your eyes and seeing what is going on all around you, and going, I can't sit by and watch this. I really strongly disagree with what's happening right now. I love London. I love the city. Yeah. I absolutely love it. And the reason why I love it and the reason why it's so wonderful is because it's multicultural.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's why it is.
If you took that away, it wouldn't be London.
Exactly. That's what it means to be British. And so it's heartbreaking, but wonderful that we get to do this movie where we get to just show people a little slice, just a little bit of what someone else might be going through.
Now I have to ask, since I have you here,
yes,
Mother of Dragons and all that.
I mean, it
is difficult to sit and look at you and not see her, which is so strange. Having read the books and known Khaleesi, and then you portrayed her so beautifully. I see you there, and you're in this lovely brown suit, but you're still her. Is there a part of you that chooses to do this kind of a film to make a departure from?
Well, it's
the
funny.
Hell of Westeros.
I know. Yeah, we left it burning, literally. It's really funny because with Game of Thrones, I'm not like Khaleesi.
No, I didn't assume, don't worry.
No. It's so funny because I do these other things, and like I did Me Before You, and every hiatus that I had, I'd do a movie pretty much. Ridiculous.
Mad.
It was sometimes a bit stupid. Yeah, I was doing a lot of acting in Game of Thrones. Like, there was a lot of acting.
Oh, you acted
going
your
on.
Ass off. Don't get me. I know you did.
So then doing stuff like this is like, that's cool. I can do that. That's great.
Is Kate like slightly easier to identify with than Khaleesi?
Yeah. Don't get me wrong. Khaleesi is etched in my heart, and she's in my bones. And I will be taking her to my deathbed with me for sure. But Game of Thrones ended and this came along and I was like, oh yeah, that'll be nice.
Was it really nice to film here and not have to do all the traveling?
It was amazing. Filming in London, it was just magic to be able to do the job that I love so much in places that felt like home. And you're like, this is cool. I did one scene with Em in Leather Lane that was over the road from my drama school. And I literally was like, if only my drama school self could see me now. Going down Leather Lane Market where I'd get my lunch every day and like maybe a nice little dress from the market. And then I'm there with Emma Thompson filming a scene going, this is so cool.
That's quite huge.
Yeah.
And it's huge to allow yourself that as well, I think, because sometimes you try and stay so humble and that's a good thing.
Yes.
But sometimes you almost wish you could go back to your past self and be like, it's all right.
You're going to be all right.
It's going to be okay. What a nice note
to end it on.
Things are going to be all right.
They're going to be all right. They're going to be all right. Yeah.
We have it here officially, I think.
Yes.
That's been Tipsy Talk. Thank you so much for watching.
Thanks.
Lovely.
Amazing.
We did not get
Thank you so much. No, I know. I do
but
that, though.
I'll pop the teapot in my handbag, though.